In this video, we're going to talk about quantifying the concentration of a solution. The most common concentration unit that we use, especially in general chemistry, is molarity. Molarity is calculated for a solution as moles of solute per liter of solution. Whenever I say the word per, that means divided by. So numerically, if I calculate how many moles of solute there are and divide by the total liters of solution, that numerical answer would be the molarity of my solution. For example, if I have 1 mole of solute, whatever it is, let's say my solute is sodium chloride, in a total of 1 liter of solution, then the molarity of my solution is 1 molarity. I would abbreviate that with a capital M, not a lowercase m, and I might simply say 1 molar instead of 1 molarity. So a 1 molar solution is a solution whose concentration is 1 molarity. A 5 molar solution has a concentration of 5 molarity, and so on. Another way to indicate concentration is to put brackets around the symbol for the solute. So brackets around NaCl would indicate that I have a solution of sodium chloride. The default for all of our solutions will be aqueous solutions unless you're told otherwise. So this is sodium chloride dissolved in water. And if I write this, that means the concentration of sodium chloride is 1 molarity. This is a way of indicating the concentration of, and that is to put these brackets around the symbol for the solute. If we come back here to the formula, an important distinction to make is this denominator is not liters of water, it's liters of total solution. To make my 1 molarity solution of sodium chloride, I don't take 1 liter of water and add a mole of sodium chloride. I take sodium chloride and water, 1 mole of sodium chloride, and enough water to give me a total of 1 liter. For that reason, the glassware that we use is called volumetric flasks. A volumetric flask is a piece of glassware that has a measurement for the volume of a solution. If you Google volumetric flasks, you can see lots of images. This is what volumetric glassware looks like. I don't know where the girls come in, but that's okay. These are all volumetric flasks. They come in a wide variety of sizes, but the shape is pretty similar. You might have a 10 milliliter one, that's an itty bitty teeny tiny one. A 100 milliliter one you can hold in your hand. This is probably a 50 milliliter one. See how big it is compared to the hand here. You can even have huge volumetric flasks. This one is 2 liters, 200 milliliters. And these can get quite expensive, but they also can be pretty large. So these are volumetric flasks. And they each have a mark on the neck, this tall, skinny neck. And when you fill this flask, you put your solute in, and then you begin adding water slowly while mixing it. And then the last couple of drops of your water for your aqueous solution are to fill it such that the meniscus is right on the mark. And then you have that volume of solution, not necessarily a certain volume of water added. And that's an important distinction to make. So back here, and you'll be seeing these in the laboratory. Let's talk more about this idea of molarity. Again, you calculate it by taking the moles of solute and divide by the liters of solution. For that reason, numerical problems that you have to work usually are phrased in such a way where they indicate the volume of solution rather than the volume of solvent or water that is added. Let's look at a simple example. This question is, what is the concentration of 250.00, and that's usually because the volumetric glassware does measure that precisely, 250 milliliter solution that contains 1.50 moles of C6H12O6. In order to calculate the molarity of this solution, it is this simple. You simply put in 1.5 moles in the numerator. 250 milliliters needs to be changed to liters. You're going to be converting milliliters to liters a lot in this chapter, and so I expect you will get quick at it, but that's 0.25. I add all these zeros if I'm worried about sig figs, liters. Punch it in my calculator, and it looks like I need to round to 3 sig figs. And so the answer is 6 molarity. I do need the extra zeros if I want to indicate the 3 sig figs. I could also say that the solution is 6 molar, or I could put brackets around the C6H12O6 and say that is equal to 6 big M for molarity. Again, this also might be abbreviated as moles per liter, with the understanding that this is moles of solute and liter of solution, not liter of water, but liters of solution. The other formula that we use for molarity is a dilution formula. So let's get that one set up real quickly. If I am diluting a solution, this is actually common practice in the laboratory. In a solution dilution, you start with a solution that's already prepared at a certain molarity, and then you take some of that solution, put it into a new container, usually a volumetric flask of some sort, and dilute it to the mark on the flask to make a new volume of solution. So let me set up a problem and then we'll work through it. All right, in this question, what is the molarity of a solution prepared by taking 10 milliliters? I do have some decimal places here. We usually use a pipette for this, and we can get to this precision on a pipette. So prepared by taking 10 milliliters of a 12 molar HCl solution and diluting to 250.00 milliliters. Again, indicating the precision of the glassware I would be using. So I have a concentrated HCl. I'm putting it into a new 250 milliliter flask and diluting to the mark. I'm expecting a molarity, a concentration that is less than the 12 molarity, because I'm diluting it. I'm making it less concentrated. In this formula, molarity equals moles of solute over liters of solution, we could rearrange it to say that the molarity times the liters is equal to the moles of the solute. The liters is of the entire solution, and the moles of solute would be, in this case, the moles of HCl. And so my original solution that I took 10 milliliters of the 12 molarity, I could think about, well, how many moles of HCl is that? And then I take that many moles and I put it into a new container and add water to dilute it, but it'll still have that many moles. And so the shortcut for a solution dilution is to say that the molarity times the liters will be the same before dilution as it is after dilution, because the moles stay the same. We write this as M1V1 equals M2V2. The big M stands for the molarity, and the V stands for the volume. Now, I've changed from liters to volume because the reality is if I have volumes on both sides, then I don't have to be in liters. I can be in milliliters. So I can use any unit of volume that I want for this equation. And so I would take the molarity times the volume of my concentrated solution. That's 10 milliliters of a 12 molarity solution. So 12 times 10. Worrying a little bit about sig figs, this is molarity times volume, which means this is the answer in moles, and that will equal the molarity times the volume of my dilute solution. I'm looking for the molarity, and my volume is 250 milliliters. And so to solve for M2, I simply rearrange. I'm not worrying about all of my zeros for sig figs, but I am going to keep them in mind as I write my final answer. It looks like I need 3 sig figs for this problem, so how about 0.480 molarity? So my dilute solution is 0.480 molarity. It is less than the molarity of my concentrated solution, which was 12 molarity, and so I did go the right direction. You should practice molarity problems.